Rabbi Goldfisher, 30 seconds to curtain.
Okay, but I just finished this makeup. Are you done?
Here's my makeup test.
I have one question left. This is really hard.
I'm not done.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the video!
Kermit, and welcome to everyone. What an amazing night as we come together to celebrate 50 years of Frisch excellence. Now, I know what you're thinking. Unfortunately, Miss Piggy couldn't be here this evening because she's not kosher.
The joke is 50 years old.
Now stop one second. I know you guys. Waldorf and Senior. Everybody who comes on the show, you heckle them. Well, you're not gonna do that to me. I've been entertaining at Frisch dinners literally half my life.
So how come we get this half?
Okay, well, I'd like to see you come down here and try to be funny.
You first!
Why are we watching a puppet show?
It's part of the brand new Cougar Plus streaming service. It celebrates 5 decades of Yeshivat Frisch.
It's actually free if you bundle it with Haiku and Veracross.
What else do they have on here besides the Muppets?
Let's try this one. It's listed as another classic of the 70s.
Welcome back.
Settle down. Settle down. Everyone. Before tomorrow's field trip, we all need to take a COVID test.
A test? But I didn't study.
Not that kind of test. It's a test so we can go to the Met.
We're going to the Met game? Awesome! Jerry Guzman, here we come!
Not the Met game, the Metropolitan Museum of Art. It's a very famous museum.
Oh, come on, Mr. Cass. The museums are for losers. Why can't we do something cool like the drive-in or the roller rink?
Yeah. You know, kids, I once felt that exact same way when I was your age, sitting in that same desk.
Oh.
What is it, Horshack?
Do you think we can be teachers in Frisch when we grow older?
That'll be the day.
Yo, was comedy actually this lame in the 70s? Or Rabbi Goldfisher and Rabbi Feldman just getting lazy?
Wait, what about the 80s? My parents love hiding pictures of themselves from the 80s. That decade must have been amazing.
Wait, let's try that one.
Night Seder? Never heard of it.
Night Seder, a shadowy group of individuals ready to delve into the challenging world of ancient Judaic texts.
But what about the Gemara in the first parak?
Michael, I believe Tosfos asks your Akasha.
No way, a talking Gemara?
You were right, the 80s were tripping.
I don't know. I think I need something a little more grounded in realism to appeal to my artistic sensibility.
Ooh, try that one.
In 1972, a group of dedicated visionary community leaders gathered in Bergen County and founded the premier modern Orthodox co-ed yeshiva high school. Nowadays, if you need to cogently present either side of a certain predetermined argument, they can do that. So, if you have a problem, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire Debate Team.
I don't know, the argument seems kind of forced.
Not to mention the bad special effects.
There's so many categories to choose from.
There are dinner videos based on musicals, witty Sherry Our Breakout videos based on the flavor of the month.
I think I'm more in the mood for a comedy. Let's try this.
Making your way in the
school today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like a hot latte?
Sometimes you wanna go where everybody likes caffeine and leave all at the back seat. You wanna be when you're not free, you're a very old lazy bean. You wanna hang when everybody's hungry. You wanna be
Hello, Norman.
What's up, Norm?
Not me. That's why I need some coffee before last period.
Actually, Normie, according to the American Academy of Sleep Medicine, it takes about 30 to 60 minutes for caffeine to reach its peak level. You know, Normie, that caffeine actually works by blocking adenosine, the neurotransmitter that makes your brain feel tired.
This conversation's making me tired.
What's wrong, Carla?
Oh, I just have a test and some homeworks and a bunch of projects. I'm very stressed.
Why don't you just talk to the teacher?
I think that'll work.
Yeah, of course. I'm sure it'll be understanding and flexible.
You sure?
Of course.
Well, I don't know, Mr. Malone. When I was in high school back in Indiana, there was this one Mr. Smithers. You can never talk to Mr. Smithers. You never get through to him.
Is that because your high school wasn't a community of kindness?
Yeah, that and that Mr. Smithers was a goat. It was our Managing Our Flock for Success program.
Hey, Sam, you think that would fly as an elective here?
I thought the den opened last year. How's this from the 80s?
Anyways, what else is on? Let's try the 90s.
What's the deal with cars? I mean, are they good or are they bad? I don't know. You've got an Apple core, you're throwing that right in the trash. Oh, but core values, you gotta keep those. And what's a core value anyway? Shouldn't all values be, you know, valuable? Oh, you're a core value. You must be really special.
How can you say it's four, Jerry? It's five. It's always been five.
Well, then why do they call it the core four?
Spirit of inquiry, pursuit of passion, religious growth, and community of kindness.
Core four?
But then there's also meaningful relationships, Jerry. Five. That's five, I tell you.
Meaningful relationships runs through the other values.
It runs through? What's runs through?
Jerry, it's the lesser value.
I beg your pardon. Meaningful relationships takes a backseat to no values. When people come into this school and say, ooh, what is that? The answer invariably is relationships. Relationships. Again and again. The lesser value, I think not.
Hey, you got a dry eraser marker? Purple?
For class?
For my friend Bob Sakamano. He's crying.
Kramer, what's your favorite of the Core Four?
Core Four, Paul McCartney. Hands down. Giddy up.
He's crazy. Elaine, list the Core Five.
Four!
Core Four, community of kindness, meaningful relationships, yada, yada, yada.
Finally done with the 90s.
They said those shows aged well, but I just don't see it.
Here we go, guys. The 2000s, the golden age of TV comedy. Yes!
Yeshivat Frisch, this is Toby. Oh, hold on 1 second. Actually, he's in a meeting right now.
Every year, we need to run a dinner to make up the deficit in our budget. I'm really not looking forward to this conversation.
What is it, Toby?
Corporate says we need to do more fundraising.
Ugh, boring. Why can't you ever give me good news, Toby?
Apparently you went over budget because you bought a Muppet?
That was for the dinner video. What are we supposed to do? 3D print our own? Listen to yourself, Toby. You sound ridiculous. Did we need to buy the Muppets? That's not the point. I thought it would take the dinner video to the next level. And it's not like we didn't use them afterwards.
Deacon, are you supposed to be in class right now? Girls, are you not supposed to use your phone in the hallways? Come on now. Come on. Hey, how you doing?
Freud was transformative in terms of how we think of psychology as a discipline. But Piaget said, waka waka. Listen, Rabbi Goldfisher, I would never tell you you're doing a bad job.
But I will! Come on, Goldie, get your act together!
That will be $75, Rabbi Sinner?
$75?
Don't worry, Rabbi Sinner! You can put it on my tab!
Why, thank you, Kermit. That is very kind of you. Okay, let's go, people. Give me your best fundraising ideas. What do you got? There are no bad ideas.
What if we...
No. Terrible. Next.
Why don't we cut the heat to the building? We can save money on the gas bill.
Way ahead of you.
But the kids will freeze.
Fact. Warmth is for the weak.
No, she's right. As assistant principal...
Assistant to the principal.
I have an idea. Why don't we ask everybody to increase their pledge to the dinner?
This is getting too cringy. But you have to love how The Office made use of the mockumentary motif. It really changed the genre.
What else could we watch in the 2000s?
We've got thermal expansion of steam. It goes through a turbine, so how do you get electricity from that?
That one started strong, but the writers didn't really have a long-term plan. And the later seasons suffered because of it.
Ooh, try that one. It's my favorite.
So, we need to talk about Zach's last few tests. And he hasn't handed in any homework. And to be honest, he doesn't really come to school anymore.
Oh, you gotta hate the fact that studios just keep churning out reboots.
I know, everything's a sequel or spinoff.
Yeah, good old plot development and multidimensional characters have really been lost.
You want complex characters? Try that drama about a chem teacher.
Ugh, another loss. We're not as young as we used to be.
I can't even feel my back.
Yeah, guess we're not as young as we used to be.
Did you just say that?
Did I? Huh, guess we're not as young as we used to be.
We should probably go see Dr. Blank again.
Hey, Dr. Blank. Think we're gonna need another one of those elixir of youth for the guys.
One youth elixir, coming right up.
Boring.
Enough with the anti-heroes.
All right, what about this?
My favorite fresh memory, personally, was in my junior year. That's when I helped lead my teammates to the varsity basketball championship at Madison Square Garden over Flatbush. That was an incredible memory.
The Flatbush game at Madison Square Garden, he chose that one. He talks about that game all the time. I'm pretty sure he scored only 2 points.
Yeah, but if you know your fresh history, the final score was 49-48. So without my 2 points, there's no banner hanging in the gymnasium.
He makes us watch that game every year on March 11th. 2 points.
All right, my head's starting to hurt.
I haven't watched this much TV since we were home for a year for that pandemic thing.
I guess we'll turn it off and go to class.
Whoa. One more.
You guys want one more?
Yeah.
Should it be a feel-good 90s sitcom theme song ballad about friendship and what makes Fish such an unbelievable school?
Yeah.
Was that too oddly specific?
Kind of.